A human boy named Shiki is raised by the Demon King robot named Ziggy at the Grand Bell Kingdom, an abandoned theme park on a remote island. Years after the death of Ziggy, travelers Rebecca Bluegarden and Happy come the planet to record online B-Cube videos at the park. Shiki frightens Rebecca with his attempts at befriending her, but she warms to him upon witnessing his friendship with the other robots. The next morning, the robots become aggressive towards Shiki and Rebecca, seemingly influenced by a virus causing them to rebel against humans. When Rebecca cries for sympathy to Shiki, he reluctantly uses Ziggy's gravity ether gear ability against the robots to rescue her, earning her friendship. Rebecca and Happy help him escape on their spaceship the Aqua Wing, revealing themselves to be from another planet in the Sakura cosmos. The robots break down from old age shortly afterwards, having staged their infection to save Shiki from solitude on planet Grand Bell. Shiki's departure is observed by a gargantuan female entity called Mother, who ponders over his future. Rebecca and Happy take Shiki to the planet Blue Garden to register him into Shooting Starlight and Adventurer's Guild, to serve as their bodyguard. At the guild, Shiki recognizes a decorative hologram of Mother, who is regarded as a mythical goddess existing beyond the Sakura cosmos. The guild members do not believe him when he said he has seen Mother before, despite remembering nothing beyond his life on Grand Bell. After Rebecca takes Shiki outside in embarrassment, Happy is captured by a member of a street gang. While Shiki battles the gang, Happy is freed and transforms into a pair of blasters Rebecca uses to defeat the gang's leader, revealing Happy was given a mechanical body to survive a traffic accident from Rebecca's childhood. Meanwhile, the space pirate Elsie Crimson learns of Shiki's departure from Grand Bell, and prepares to follow him to Blue Garden. Shiki continues to be ridiculed by the members of Shooting Starlight, while Rebecca is treated similarly by her guildmate Lobelia Christie, a more popular B-Cuber. Disillusioned with the guild after defending Rebecca from Lobelia, Shiki proposes to his friends they embark on their own adventure by finding Mother and record a video to prove her existence. They travel to the planet Norma to obtain a more spaceworthy ship from Professor Y. Steiner, Rebecca and Happy's benefactor. They are missed by Elsie, who claims Norma to be a dead planet. Upon arriving in Wise's house, the three are held at gunpoint by an unfamiliar young man using the professor's name. 20,000 years in the future, two androids discover a pair of human remains on a barren world along with Rebecca's recording device, which is inscribed with the words Eden Zero. At Wise's house, the stranger escapes from an ambush arranged by the crime boss Sibir, from whom the stranger has stolen a briefcase. Rebecca deduces that her group has traveled 50 years back in time, with the stranger being Wise's past self. After encountering Wise again while hiding from Sibir, Shiki accidentally opens the briefcase and finds a small android inside named EM Pino, whose electromagnetic pulse disables machinery and ether gear. Pino identifies Sibir as her master and fearfully returns to him, leaving behind a B-Cube recording revealing Sibir mistreating her and erasing her memory of her previous master. Learning from her briefcase's maintenance log she comes from the present era, Shiki and his friends agree to rescue her to stop Sibir from altering history with her technology. Shiki's group arrives at Sibir's base to rescue Pino, but Wise takes her for himself and hijacks their motorcycle to escape, with Sibir chasing after Wise with his night gear mech. During the confrontation with Sibir's henchmen, Shiki witnesses the death of a robot resembling his friend Michael from Grand Bell underneath the base, where Sibir has discarded countless other identical robots he has tortured. Shiki is enraged by Sibir's cruelty towards robots and defeats him, which inspires Pino to disable the Night Gear's self-destruct mechanism when Sibir's bird companion activates it, saving Shiki. Meanwhile, Elsie approaches Norma, with her ship's interior now covered in an organic growth. Shiki's group take Pino to have her memory repaired by the present-day Wise, believing him to be her original master. They attempt to leave Norma, but the Aqua Wing is blocked by an energy field surrounding the planet. Wise, who has stowed aboard the Aqua Wing to evade the police, helps them bypass the field by using his Machina Maker ether gear to upgrade the ship. The group is contacted by the present-day Wise, who reveals Pino's master to be Ziggy. He further explains that the group did not travel to the past, but entered an alternate history created by a chronophage, a time-eating space monster who reversed 50 years of Norma's time. making himself and the young Wise separate individuals, the Aqua Wing is suddenly captured by Elsie and brought aboard her ship, the Skull Fairy. Threatened with enslavement on the lawless planet Gilst, Shiki challenges Elsie over the ownership of the Skull Fairy, which is infested with alien parasites mimicking human forms. Upon reaching the ship's bridge, Shiki is startled to see a skull-faced Elsie. After a struggle with Elsie, Shiki enters a new form and overpowers her upon learning of Ziggy's failure to find Mother, which gives him the resolve to achieve Ziggy's dream. Elsie's defeat causes her to change into a small alien creature, revealing her to be a parasite mimicking Elsie. The real Elsie congratulates Shiki from a nearby fleet and rewards him with the ship, having been entrusted by Ziggy to deliver it to Shiki from the beginning. Engaged in a battle with the Interstellar Union Army, Elsie provides cover for Shiki's group as Wise activates the ship's warp drive and sends them near Blue Garden. The group cleans and explores the ship, during which time Rebecca finds a bath giving her powers similar to Aether Gear. In Ziggy's chamber, Shiki unwittingly activates an android named Witch Regret, who reverts the ship to its original form, the warship Eden Zero. Witch advises Shiki's group to gather her fellow androids, the Demon King's four shining stars, to ensure the Eden Zero's passage through Dragonfall, a dragon swarm which borders the Sakura cosmos. After Wise leaves to indulge in the present era, Shiki's group visits Shooting Starlight to investigate Sister Ivory, one of the missing androids. While Rebecca attends a meeting with the Guild Master, Shiki saves Lobelia from being abducted by Jin, a cyborg and Wind Aether Gear user who works for Sister. Shiki and Jin battle each other until Jin receives orders to retreat, inviting Shiki to a rematch on Gilst. Later, Shiki finds Happy damaged from an assault on Rebecca, who has gone missing, followed by a news report about several B-Cuber abductions. Realizing Jin's involvement, Shiki's group prepares to disembark to Gilst, overheard by a kimono-wearing girl who is familiar with the Eden Zero. Rebecca and the other captured B-Cubers are delivered to Gilst by Rogue Out Sister's mercenary squad. Rogue Out's patron Elega, a collector of petrified women, prepares the B-Cubers for petrification by flooding their cell with a foam which dissolves their clothing. Meanwhile, Wise returns to the Eden Zero with the kimono-wearing girl Hamura Kogetsu, with whom he has made a deal to grant her access to the ship after learning of Rebecca's abduction. Hamura offers to help rescue Rebecca in exchange for the opportunity to duel the Demon King Shiki, revealing herself to use an Aether Gear that Witch recognizes. Shiki's team reaches Rogue Out's headquarters, where they are confronted by Sister. Hamura uses her Soul Blade Aether Gear to defeat Sister's soldiers, allowing Shiki and Pino to stow beneath Sister's ship as she disembarks to Elega's tower. Wise becomes suspicious of Hamura and threatens her by shooting Mosco Versa Zero, an intervening Rogue Out member, with a battery of turrets. Meanwhile, Rebecca rallies the other B-Cubers to form a human pyramid and help her reach their cell's elevated glass window, using the clothes dissolving foam to escape. Elega corners Rebecca, but Shiki finds them and violently assails Elega. Pino calms Shiki by using her EMP to deactivate his Aether Gear, which unlocks the B-Cuber's cell, freeing them. Jin locates Shiki, who fends him off as Pino leads the B-Cubers to safety, aboard the Eden Zero, which detects a chronophage approaching Gilst. Jin is approached by Sister and her minion gone off during his battle with Shiki, who challenges all three at once. As this happens, Hamura finds a second android named Sister captive beneath Rogue Out's headquarters, and convinces Wise to release the android. After Shiki defeats the Rogue Out trio, the second Sister exposes their leader as an imposter who kept her imprisoned for 10 years to harness her healing powers. Sister revives Elega's petrified victims before joining Shiki's group to escape from the chronophage. Jin kills the imposter, accusing her of falsely promising to save his younger sister clean. Meanwhile, Rebecca subdues Elega to rescue a B-Cuber who has fallen behind during their escape. Following the revival of Elega's victims, Rebecca allows them to evacuate with the other B-Cubers while she waits for Shiki, with 10 minutes remaining until the chronophage's arrival. Shiki reunites with Rebecca and Pino in the chaos surrounding the chronophage's approach, using his gravity to drop his group directly onto the Eden Zero to escape. The chronophage consumes 1,200 years of Gilst's time, killing most of the planet's population while restoring its pristine nature. Among those who escape is Draken Joe, one of six intergalactic outlaws called the Oration Cease Galactica, Aboard the Eden Zero, Hamura reveals herself to be a pupil of Valkyrie Yuna, one of the missing shining stars. Hamura and Wise are accepted as permanent crew members, as is a reprogrammed Mosko who is revealed to be from the ship's original crew. Following sister's intuition, the crew visit the monument Iron Hill orbiting Blue Garden, where they immediately find Hermit Mio, another of the four shining stars. The Eden Zero crew learn the Hermit is in a catatonic state caused by psychological trauma, which determines the Hermit's mind is secluded within Digitalis, a virtual planet and server for the massively multiplayer online role-playing game Rogue Fantasia. Shiki's team enters the game by uploading their consciousness into digital avatars, warned by which any injuries and deaths sustained in the virtual world will affect their physical bodies. After interrogating the game's sentient NPCs, the team travels to the city near Hermit's location and encounters Jamilov, a player and affiliate of Draken Joe who is notorious for killing NPCs and other players without being banned from the game. After Jamilov logs out to attend a meeting with Draken, Shiki's team reaches Hermit and tries persuading her to return to the Eden Zero, but she sends them away out of hatred for humans. Returning to the city, the team witnesses an oncoming siege of enemy monsters have been reprogrammed by Jamilov to kill the surviving NPCs. Shiki rescues Hermit from the monsters while his teammates help protect the city. Meanwhile, Hamura appears to betray the Eden Zero crew by allying with Jamilov, intent on joining Draken's ranks. As Hamura openly reveals her intentions to the team after Shiki returns with Hermit, a second Hamura with a different avatar arrives and saves Shiki from being killed by the monster army. The traitor Hamura unmasks herself as Amira, a shape-shifting government agent who is investigating Draken, and flees after failing to kill the real Hamura, finding Jamilov is using cheats to gain advantages over Shiki. Hermit begrudgingly helps Shiki fight through her own cheats, using the Willing Wise's account to avoid being banned. Driven to frustration, Jamilov enters a computer code which begins deleting the game world and characters. Hermit is initially indifferent towards the NPCs, but is swayed into undoing the code when Shiki declares them to be living beings. After Shiki defeats Jamilov, Hermit agrees to temporarily exit the game, but continues to isolate herself. The Eden Zero's computer systems are then hacked by Jamilov's real-world persona Spider, who gains full control over the ship. As Spider destroys the Eden Zero from within, Hermit despairingly tells the crew to evacuate without her, reflecting on the incident that disillusioned her from humans. 15 years in the past, Hermit seeks to befriend the human Dr. Muller and his research team, whom she assists in developing a machine to provide energy to the dying robot planet Hook. To her horror, the machine obliterates Hook and her robot colleagues stationed there, while Muller and the other humans celebrate, revealing that they engineered the disaster as an act of contempt towards robots. Muller conducts torturous experiments on Hermit for the next 2 years until he and his team are arrested, leaving a traumatized Hermit to distance herself from all human contact. Back in the present, the crew refuses to abandon Hermit against her objections, leading her to realize that she still desires friendship with humans. Assured by Shiki, Hermit restores the ship's systems and humiliates Spider with a prank missile attack, returning to her old cheerful self. Spider seeks for Draken to retaliate against the Eden Zero crew, but Draken has him executed for his incompetence. Believing he can profit off of the Eden Zero, Draken contacts Shooting Starlight's master Noah Glenfield for information on the ship. Meanwhile, suspecting Noah to be involved with Rebecca's abduction in the events surrounding Gilst, the crew travel to consult an omniscient fortune teller on the planet Mildian over Valkyrie's whereabouts, spending the voyage modeling costumes in the ship's dress factory as part of Wise's deal with Hamura. They then meet the fortune teller Xiaomei, who sends Shiki's team to a battle coliseum within her temple to compensate for her knowledge. Xiaomei challenges each member of Shiki's group to a series of duels to indulge her obsession with watching battles, as she has restricted her powers to prevent herself from foreseeing their outcomes. Shiki immediately defeats the first opponent, a metallic warrior, with a single punch. Rebecca wins the second match against a B-cuber who uses a bullet-resistant force field, which she easily bypasses with an ordinary kick. And Wise exploits a loophole in the rules to use Pino's EMP against the third opponent, an ether gear user with superhuman speed. For the final match, Hamura is pit against a supposed replica of Valkyrie, whom she discovers to actually be a training robot programmed by Xiaomei to act the part after defeating her. Satisfied, Xiaomei reveals the real Valkyrie to be on the planet Sun Jewel, and warns the crew of future confrontations against others who seek Mother. The crew anticipate a three-day voyage to Sun Jewel to avoid a hazardous debris field near the planet. En route, they rescue a shipwrecked captain named Connor from a passing school of fish in space. Connor exhausts the crew's hospitality with his intrusive behavior and poor manners, but when the crew confront him for unauthorized piloting of the ship, they find that he has safely brought them to Sun Jewel through the debris field within the first day of the voyage. He remains aboard the ship, withholding the name of his original ship, Eden's One. Wise remains behind to construct a new weapon while Shiki's group investigates Sun Jewel, where Shiki and Hamura thwart a casino robbery. Madame Kurinai, the planet's ruler and an associate of Draken, publicly executes the robbers with a laser-mounted satellite called Satellite Blaze. For their use of violence against the robbers, Shiki and Hamura are branded as criminals by Kurinai's emissaries, who fire the same laser on them. Shiki and Hamura are transported to Sun Jewel's labor district, where they are sentenced to harvest a quota of precious metals from alien monsters called stones alongside the planet's impoverished citizens. The two run afoul of Kurinai's henchman Garot, the district's cruel warden, who lashes Hamura with his paralyzing whip and takes her away. Ignoring Garrett's threats against the other laborers, Shiki confronts him to rescue Hamura. In the rich sector, Lobelia offers to help Rebecca's group enter the labor district in exchange for a B-Cube collaboration as repayment for Shiki rescuing her from Jin. However, the video is revealed to be a malicious prank on Rebecca, and Lobelia reneges her promise after publicly humiliating her. Rebecca gains the sympathy of Nino, a fellow B-Cuber in the video's audience, who offers to guide her to the labor district himself. Nino reveals himself to be a benign agent of Madame Kurinai and allows Rebecca's group to access the labor district. The group meets Paul, a disciple of Valkyrie with a B-cube that contains the truth of her circumstances, which he hesitates to reveal to Hamura. Meanwhile, Garot transports Shiki and Hamura to the Den of Black Rock, Sun Jewel's most powerful and valuable stone, where they reunite with Rebecca's group. The group defeats Black Rock and fulfills the quotas displayed on Shiki and Hamura's slave collars, expecting this to free them, but the quotas immediately reset to their original values. Convinced of Hamura's resolve, Paul removes the collars with his thievery ether gear and gives her the B-cube. In the rich sector, having decided to double-cross Draken by claiming the Eden Zero for herself, Kurinai readies her satellite to eradicate the labor district. 10 years in the past, Valkyrie raises an orphaned Hamura on the planet Edo, where their relationship faces disapproval from natives who are prejudiced against machines. 5 years into her training, Hamura is reprimanded by a local magistrate when she attacks his son for insulting Valkyrie. The magistrate convinces Valkyrie that Hamura needs her biological mother, who is revealed to be Kurinai. Finding Kurinai enslaved in debt at Sun Jewel's labor district, Valkyrie takes her place so that Kurinai may reunite with Hamura. 2 years later, Valkyrie learns that Kurinai has since remained on Sun Jewel and usurped the planet's previous ruler, having never intended to return to Hamura. After Kurinai provokes a horde of stones into attacking the district, Valkyrie slays the horde to defend the other laborers but perishes. Back in the present, Hamura finds her teacher's remains and is devastated when Pino confirms that Valkyrie is beyond repair. Shiki consoles Hamura and leaves her to grieve while he confronts Kurinai, resolving to bring her to Hamura for judgment in Valkyrie's stead. During Shiki's battle with Kurinai's forces, Draken steals the satellite Blaze as retribution for Kurinai's betrayal and prepares to seize the Eden Zero in combat. Kurinai sends Garot, a reluctant Nino, and their companion Baku to attack the labor district while she battles Shiki with her night gear, the Kurinai Dragoon. Rebecca tries recruiting Hamura to aid the laborers against Kurinai's forces, but decides against it upon finding her still in a stupor over Valkyrie's death, and offers her own words of encouragement instead. Baku is defeated by Wise, who has assumed a superhero alter ego named Arsenal, with his completed weapon, a mechanical suit that he modifies with his ether gear. As Shiki brings his battle with Kurinai into the labor district, Rebecca is forced to fight Nino when he traps her group during a supply run. After Nino defeats Rebecca, she notices several parallels between the crew's battles on Sun Jewel and Mildian. discovering hints that allow her to manifest an ether gear in her legs. Her ether gear rewinds time to the moment before her defeat, allowing her to subdue Nino. She names her ether gear Leaper, after her newly enhanced speed, unaware of its true power. Meanwhile, Hamira notices the laborer's battle and attempts to join her allies, but is paralyzed as a delayed effect from Garrett's earlier lashing. Angered when Garrett desecrates Valkyrie's remains, Hamira musters the strength to dislodge Valkyrie's sword with her own energy blades and impale him with it. She recovers and reunites with Rebecca's group afterward, thanking her friends for helping her overcome her grief. Shiki uses the Kurenai Dragoon's missiles to strengthen his powers and destroy the mech. After Nino deactivates Kurenai's robot army, Shiki and Paul elect Hamira to decide Kurenai's fate. Kurenai feigns compassion for Hamira to gain her forgiveness, but Hamira determines Valkyrie to be her true mother and sends Kurenai into exile. Kurenai is assaulted and taken captive by one of her previous victims shortly afterwards. Shiki's team leaves Valkyrie enshrined on Sun Jewel and returns to the Eden Zero, which has evaded Draken, to inform the crew of Valkyrie's death. Witch and sister argue over recreating Valkyrie from her backup data, which would result in a different android lacking the original's emotional ties to Hamira. Agreeing with Shiki that they must accept their loss, Hamira offers herself as Valkyrie's substitute in the Four Shining Stars. The Shining Stars welcome Hamira and mourn for Valkyrie before the crew continue on their journey pursued by Draken. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.